something interesting to think about. Everything you've done in your life, everything, every minute little thing led you to this point right now. You sitting here watching this video. So let's not waste any more time and get right into it. What do you say? This is just going to be a list of items I think you should look into if you're a video creator or if you just make videos in general. Here we go. Lights, camera, action. Lights, power, action. There's all kinds of different lighting gear that's out there. There's one consistent thing, and that's the power adapter. Typically, it's a two-prong little receiver adapter thing. I don't know what the technical name is. It's this thing right here. In my experience, this cord is always too short, and it's frustrating because it typically plugs into the converter box, which hangs on your light stand, and it's just a whole other issue altogether. I'll have to do a video on that. One thing that I think you should look into is getting an extension cable. Yes, you can buy longer cords and plug them into this, and you don't have to deal with this dangling little box. You can just strap it to the light stand and be on your way. I like to set up my lights like this, where it has a little bit of a support system for the cord. I hang it up, and I always keep these little twist ties. I tie them to the cords whenever I get them, just so I can use them to tie up cords when I'm not using them, like these short little torque cords. And I replace it with the longer ones. And look at this. I mean, right there, boom. This is probably not even long enough. I'm gonna look it up right now and see if there's even longer ones, because why even have an extension cord if I don't need one? Am I right? That definitely is something that you wanna look into, and you wanna check the exact power connection you have. Some of them are the three-prong setup. Speaking of video lights, I have all kinds of lights that I've used in my long years of amateur video making. I do have a list in the description of this video with all of the things I'm talking about, including some lights. I'm not going to get into the specific lights, but I want to talk about batteries. Nah, I know what you're thinking. I've heard of these batteries. Not these batteries. These NPF style batteries have USB connections on them. So the benefit of having a battery with a USB plug is that you can have a portable power supply that you can plug in and charge anything else. Charge your phone. Charge a camera, run a camera off of it. You can do all kinds of stuff, and you can power your lights with these batteries. That's one of the best benefits of it. If you don't even want to deal with cords, you just get a couple of these batteries. They have a plug to charge on them, so you don't even need a charging base. More universal than just a simple battery pack that is only good for one thing, which is charging things, where these can actually be plugged into your lights and power your lights or even your camera or monitors. So definitely look into those batteries if you haven't heard of those before. There's all kinds of different kinds. I don't know which ones are the best. I bought a couple. They're still working for me. I actually use them consistently to plug in my phone and charge it. So another thing, talking about power, I would recommend, if you haven't already looked into it, camera battery adapter. Is that what it's called? AC power adapter battery connectors. And I would recommend looking into one of those if you haven't already, especially if you run into the frustration of you're in the middle of shooting something and right when you get the momentum up, you gotta switch out batteries because you get that flashing light. And the same with this power adapter, I would recommend buying one of those extension cables so the cord going to the power box isn't gonna get in the way. Definitely worth looking into. Power adapter, and you wanna look for your specific camera model. This one's for the Panasonic. While we're talking about lights, let's talk about little portable lights, specifically these little gems right here. I have used this little light more than any light that I've ever owned because it's just bright enough to get the little accent lights that I want, and it's portable, built-in battery, charge it up. You can adjust the power level of it. I usually keep this one at like 20%. It's totally bright enough, and you can adjust the color temperature. There's a couple of versions out there. You can look into which one works best for you. I'll put a link in the description, like I said, of all of these things. So when I'm shooting B-roll stuff like this, I just set the light up, I can illuminate my front shot. I like to use this light as a backlight so I can set it behind the subject that I'm recording, in this case, this little 3D printer, and oh, look at that. Now here's definitely one of the other additional things you wanna look into, which are ball heads, miniature ball heads. It's not just any old ball head, metal ball heads. If you have a little mini light that you're gonna start using, you'll definitely wanna get one of these. I have this one set up with a magnetic base. It actually is a lot more useful than I thought it would. And I can just stick it to the door or just stick it to a table or tripod even. There's a lot of different ball heads. I know in my experience, the smaller ones have been more useful for me. I definitely wanna look into a magnetic base just to have in the bag. Now we're getting into the little nooks and crannies of things. A couple other little gems you wanna look into are these little hot shoe, cold shoe, okay? You can see here, these have quarter 20 mounts on one side, and the other side is the little slide for your flash or your lighting gear. I've actually used these a lot where you can mount these little slides, I call them slides, but you can mount these cold shoes on things, and if you're switching out microphones, or if you have these small lights, you can just slide them in there and you don't need a dedicated quarter 20 mount. They have like the mounting slide part and then the receiving end, and you can see these different parts. I think it's worth having a couple of these in the bag. You'll definitely get some use out of them if you're using microphones and mounting those different places. I like them for mics and for small lights. Definitely something to look into if you haven't already. There's one thing that's been lost in the mix all these years, and it was a big deal back in the day. The magic arm, the adjustable magic arm. These arms come in different lengths. You tighten one knob, everything kind of loosens up, you twist it, and it tightens all the connectors. It's really, really unique piece of machinery, and they're relatively cheap. One of the biggest benefits, especially if you're purchasing one of these on eBay or as a bundle kit, which is what I recommend, you want to look for these extra little adapters, which have the cold shoe adapters, the little sliders, these weird little quarter 20 tightener pieces. These weird connections I've used more than I thought I would ever need to. And it's like, I don't even know what they're specifically called. This one has the little clamp that lets you clamp to like a light stand or a tripod, which I think this setup is ideal because you have magic arm, the mounting clamp, and then you have these little adapters on the end that you can mount anything. You can mount lights, a flash for a camera. I mentioned it a little bit earlier of just keeping the twist ties on the cords. I would recommend getting some of these loopable rubber twist ties. They're long. They're about, I don't know, 20 inches or so, and they're metal coated in rubber. Night Ease is one of the brands that I've seen. I've used these on multiple occasions. You just throw them in the bag and don't even think about it, and you'll know when you need it. We had a setup where I had a small tripod and I wasn't totally sure if the camera was gonna sit correctly, so I used those twist ties to just tighten everything down around this post. And so just to add some extra security, whatever. This is a lot of information. You can find these at the hardware store and I don't know, near the key aisle, wherever they keep the keys, because over in that section, there's another thing, which is this Night Ease keychain. And I've talked about this before in other video. This little wristband is a perfect little focus assist. You just slide it around your lens and it gives you a little extra grip for when you're focusing. I don't know, I still use mine. This is just stuff that you throw in the bag and it doesn't take up a lot of room, but it comes in handy sometimes if you're running manual focus, if you're running a camera like that. Mic stands. I have recommended this in the past. I still use mine from, I don't know, 10 years ago I made a video about it. It's a microphone stand with a boom arm. They're basically like cheap C stands in a way. That's how I use mine. You put a little sandbag or weight at the bottom of it and you can mount your mics. I recommend switching out the standard mic adapter, which is pretty useless for most stuff, unless you have just a mic to hold up there. And I would recommend getting one of these clothespin style microphone clips because you can actually clip a lot of things. I still clip in my Zoom H1. Fits really nice in there. With that, another little adapter is this little 5/8-27 to quarter 20 adapter. This will go on the end of any mic stand. It's worth having a set of these. They're pretty cheap. Just buy a couple, because even if you have these in your bag, you'll be surprised. There's usually in most locations a mic stand around if you're shooting weddings and stuff, and you can always just mount lights or a camera to a mic stand if you needed to. So these little adapters are definitely useful. We're rounding home plate. Wait, is that how that works? How does baseball work again? This is the L bracket. This is probably one of my favorite pieces of gear. The price range is, it varies. It goes from like $5 to $10. Sometimes you'll even see them listed for $20. I wouldn't pay more than $10 for one of these. You can find them on eBay and Amazon. This little simple L bracket has two cold shoe adapters to the top, and it's just a simple L bracket. And I have this in my bag just as an emergency handle for my camera. And it's helpful when you want to mount additional gear like a light or even a monitor if you want to keep it off of your camera. It's not the most comfortable and ergonomic handle. Obviously, it's pretty cheap and there's definitely different options for something like that if you're looking for something a little bit more robust. But for this, just a cheap little backup mount, it's worth having in your camera bag. The L bracket, knob top recommended. Now, the final thing I want to talk about should be first on the list, but I wanted to give you something to look forward to, which doesn't make any sense, but here we go. It's this little tabletop tripod. Manfrotto makes the official version, I'm pretty sure, and this is just a replica, and it works just as good, I think. This little combo pack specifically is the way to go, and this is a combo thing as well. The tripod itself is very useful for small cameras, phones specifically, but because this one also comes with a phone adapter, tripod mount. I think it's the best deal you can get and it'll be the most useful. In fact, I would recommend having like two or three of these around. Having one of these mounts, specifically these tripod mounts for the phone, have these twist adjusters that let you adjust to your specific phone size. I recommend these over the spring-loaded ones. I just feel like for the larger phones, those spring-loaded ones kind of max out. I think this is the best deal to just buy it as a combo pack because the little mount itself costs about $5 or $6. So to get a little tripod is helpful, but definitely the phone mount is the main thing you're gonna want. I use my phone so much more because I have those mounts readily available all over. And also it's really nice just sitting on your desk if you just want to mount your phone in there to check messages while you're supposed to be working. You know, you can set your phone up and it actually, this is what's so great about this, it pivots from vertical to horizontal. I think that's amazing. So this is definitely a list of some things that I think everybody should look into having. I get a lot of use out of all the things I've listed. I own all the things, I've used them for years, and I guess in some cases almost over 10 years I've been using this stuff, and it's still been useful. The number one thing for sure is the phone mount. So there you go. I hope that was helpful. Not top. Go make something.